Sync 13, take one.
In those early days of being at EMI, I was very much aware how good American drums sounded on record to how they sounded over here. And I soon realised when I went into Abbey Road for the first time, the engineer, Peter Bowne, just put one mic above the kit. And I said to Peter, "Peter, I'm going to be using the bass drum on this phrasing with the vocals. The bass drum's quite important. I'd like to get that sound like Don LeMond has with, you know, like a crack of a bass drum." Anyway, we're having a break now. So, right, off we went. We had a break. We were into the Abbey Tavern. "Peter, we'd like a drink." So a couple of whiskey mics. Back round to do the evening session. Peter put the mic on, we dumped the bass drum, and voila, it sounds just as I wanted it.
Riding along on a carousel, trying to catch up to you. Riding along on a carousel, will I catch up to you? Horses chasing, 'cause they're racing, so near yet so far.
The Hollies, in their early experience, were never even allowed to touch the board itself. You know, so if we said, you know, "Can we have a little more of that bass drum?" You know, and you would... No. It has to be the engineer that does it, you know. After you started to sell records, everything changed. When you started to sell millions of pieces of plasticware, they couldn't tell you what to do.
Mark it. 11, take two.
Riding along on a carousel, trying to catch up to you. Riding along on a carousel, will I catch up to you? Horses chasing, 'cause they're racing, so near yet so far. On a carousel, on a carousel, near and nearer by changing horses, still so far away. People fighting for their places, just get in my way.
We always used to do the choruses round one microphone facing each other, because it was too difficult to let maybe Alan put his... I mean, he did put his solo pieces on, but we always sort of said, "Let's all stand round." And I used to literally just watch his mouth and follow it, because that's a lot easier and more accurate than if he's recorded it and then say, "Right, go down and do yours" and things. And the slightest variation on the phrasing and you've got to start again and things. So that's how we used to get the harmonies in perfect time.
Horses chasing, 'cause they're racing, so near yet so far. changing horses, still so far away. People fighting for their places, just get in my way. Soon you leave and then I lose you, still we're going round on the carousel, on the carousel.
The studio's in Abbey Road 1, 2 and 3. The famous one is Studio 2, where the Beatles made nearly all of their music, and indeed so did we. Number 3 we used quite a lot, and on many occasions we'd be in 3, the Beatles would be in 2, and I remember George coming up and listening to a couple of things we did, and, you know, we were invited in to listen to what they were doing. Paul would be around. It was very friendly. There's no rivalry or anything.
We were in Studio 3, Abbey Road, January 17th, 1967. We started recording On A Carousel, and the studio's doors burst open, and George Martin walked in with a Granada film crew. You know, we're just about to do a take, red lights on. There's me playing the track with a camera stuck up my nose, and it was a little bit disconcerting trying to, you know, trying to record and concentrate with these camera guys walking about. But apparently, later in that day, George was across in number 2 with Paul and the Beatles track, Penny Lane, overdubbing the little trumpet. Da, 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 da.
OK, fellas, let's do a take.
It's really
crucial, isn't it?
Riding along on a carousel, trying to catch up to you. Riding along on a carousel, will I catch up to you? Horses chasing, 'cause they're racing, so near yet so far.
She drops the